Hello, my name is Timothy Catron, and I am a geologist and volcanologist. I know a great deal about volcanoes, and I've traveled to many of them in person. While this is what real molten lava looks like, this is also lava in the video game Minecraft. Minecraft shares many geologic features with the real world, such as ore deposits, caves, ravines, and geodes, all of which have their real world counterparts. It even has multiple volcanic rock types such as basalt, andesite, and obsidian. And yet, a lot of Minecraft isn't geologically accurate. I mean, it's not meant to be. For example, in the game, finding a lava lake while uncommon is way too abundant compared to the real world. Since one block in Minecraft is 1 meter wide, in a sample 4 square kilometer region I checked, there were 7 surface lava lakes. Yet, around the globe, there are in the real world only 6 currently active lava lakes. Yeah, that's it. And all of these aren't at random spots in the ground in the middle of a forest, but each are at the summit of actively erupting volcanoes. As if a lava lake exists and is molten, a volcano by definition is erupting. But let's ignore that and focus on the lava. In the real world, all lava around the globe isn't homogeneous. In fact, there are more than a dozen separate compositions of lava, and each of these behave in a different manner. Some, such as basalt, are fairly fluid, forming thin lava flows that can easily reach fairly high distances away from an erupting vent. Meanwhile, other lavas are far more viscous, building up into steep structures known as lava domes. So, based on this, what exactly is the composition of Minecraft's lava? There is technically not a clear-cut answer to this, despite the fact that both basalt and andesite rock types exist in the game. As if you were to pull in-game lava flows, it wouldn't leave behind either of these rock types, but instead just cobblestone. Therefore, we have to make our assessment based on the physical properties of the observed lava flow via how it behaves. In the Minecraft overworld, lava moves at a speed of 0.666 meters per second, translating to a speed of 2.4 kilometers per hour or 1.5 miles per hour. Among the lava varieties, that is actually pretty fast all things considered. The more silica-rich a lava becomes, the slower it moves due to the increased presence of thick, sticky chains of silica molecules that increase its viscosity. So, if we were to just go off of speed, what compositions could Minecraft's lava be? Somewhere between foidite and basaltic andesite. However, it's best to use a few other tests as well. One thing to look for is the lava's temperature, as this can help determine its composition. Lava varieties can range in temperature from 550 degrees Celsius to 1700 degrees Celsius, with generally speaking, lavas becoming colder the more silica-rich they are. But how might we determine how hot Minecraft's lava flows are? Simple. There's an in-game feature where lava can occasionally ignite very close by flammable blocks, causing them to burn. And after looking through what blocks can burn, the object with the highest ignition temperature that can be ignited from a lava flow is surprisingly wool. With an ignition temperature of 600 degrees Celsius, if we assume that wool was ignited by a nearby lava flow in-game, that temperature would only disqualify two of the more exotic lava varieties, natural carbonatite and carbonatite. And if we look at the behavior of lava flows in-game, they do not form lava domes or tall lava lobes, instead just forming thin lava flows. Such behavior best matches with a composition ranging from foidite to basalt. So, with all of that in mind, what is the best composition match of Minecraft's lava? In my opinion, basalt, which commonly forms shield volcanoes worldwide, but can also create cinder cones, explosion craters, and in rare instances, stratovolcanoes. However, Minecraft also has essentially its own version of hell called the Nether, and in this dimension, lava moves 3 times faster at a speed of 7.2 kilometers per hour. While with this speed, a composition of pecrobasalt, foidite, or comatite might seem like a better match, the Nether also contains widespread basalt deltas. With basalt being so common there, it only makes sense that the surrounding abundant lava is also basaltic in composition, just less silica-rich than in the overworld. I hope that you found this different video of mine interesting. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Momo the Peach, for supporting my work.